Well, we're about to get things started with our opening bout. Let's go up to ring announcer. That'll be joining us shortly on the broadcast. Mr. Chris Gauthier.
Please welcome to the ring, Richard Vorus.
First combatant coming into the ring, Richard Vorus, Budapest, Hungary. He will take on, me and you have been studying this name for about 3 days now. Mark Hakkali Wagon.
That's right, Richard Vorus, all the way from Hungary. Hungarian opponents very popular here in Canada, as you'll notice if you continue watching a lot of these Canadian cards. Richard Vorus lost to Ian Butcher in 77 seconds earlier this year in September. He lost to Khalid Yafai in 68 seconds. I'm sure he's hoping his outing tonight isn't quite as brief. Montreal's a nice place, Mark, so I would hope that he'd want to stay for a little while.
You mentioned those two outings. Actually, I think those are good outings compared to his last fight, when he lost to a fellow named Rafael, 22-62-1.
The most success in terms of victories, but still, as he takes on Mark Hakkali Wagon, Guapo, Richard Vorus still much more experienced, and he's had 14 pro fights, so maybe give him a little bit of a test here in our opener.
Mark Hakkali Wagon.
As you mentioned, Hakkali Wagon, obviously the past week we've been talking a lot about Manny Pacquiao, and he's kind of opened the floodgates in the past decade or so of fighters of Filipino descent making their mark all over the world. And Mark Kelly Wagon could be the next one. I mean, he's a guy of Ontario, one of the first of his Filipino Canadians. But obviously there has to be some influence there from the Pacquiao success.
No question. He said that he started boxing because he saw Manny Pacquiao on TV, and he decided, okay, this is something I want to do. He's the first Filipino to ever fight here at the Bell Center, and he, because of that connection, that Filipino connection, the impact that Manny Pacquiao has had on that community, he sold over 200 tickets for this event on his own. There are a lot of fighters in the world, big name fighters that you would see on network television, that can't always say that necessarily. So Hakkali Wagon already has a backing in his young career. We'll see if he can back it up in the ring.
And he's actually from Ontario, so that for them to come all the way over to Quebec, that says something about the potential dynamic fight that we have in Hakkali Wagon.
Well, I suppose the people coming in from London, Ontario, can give him something to cheer about.
Let's go to ring announcer Chris Gauthier.
Mesdames et messieurs. Mesdames et messieurs, ce combat est prévu pour 4 rounds dans la catégorie des Supercoq, une co-présentation de mise au jeu et Vidéotron. This fight consists of 4 rounds of action in the Super Featherweight Division, a co-presentation of mise au jeu and Vidéotron, and presented in association with Hennessy Sports, sponsored by Liquid Caffeinated Water. Les juges pour ce combat, the 3 judges sitting at ringside to score this bout, Jean Lapointe, Sylvain Leblanc, et Benoît Roussel. L'arbitre, referee in charge, Jean-Guy Brousseau. D'abord dans le coin rouge, portant la culotte rouge et blanche et pesant 120,4 livres. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red trunks with the white trim, his official weight, 120.4 pounds. En 14 combats, il a 4 victoires, dont une par KO. His professional record shows 4 victories. Including 1 coming by way of knockout in 14 bouts de Budapest en Hongrie, Richard Vorus. Mon adversaire dans le coin bleu porte la culotte rouge ornée de noir et de blanc et pèse 122,4 livres. Looking across the ring, his opponent fights out of the blue corner, wears the red trunks with the black and white trim. He weighed in at 122.4 pounds. Il a remporté son seul combat professionnel par KO. He has won his only professional bout by knockout from London, Ontario, Mark Guapo Hakkali Wagon.
Let's go,
Looks out.
You receive my instruction in dressing room. I want clean fight. Obey my command and protect yourself at all times. Touch love. Good luck.
22-year-old Mark Pageli Wongan and Richard Baroche start things up.
You see the tail of the tape. Pageli Wongan with 2 inches advantage in terms of height, but he's also a naturally bigger guy. Before he started boxing, he walked around about 150 pounds. Now he says he's in his comfortable weight around 126.
He's coming out with 4, 5, 6 jabs in a row. Good body shot.
Book on Guapo. He likes to throw as many punches as possible, and that may be his undoing as he moves up in competition, but it's going to make him a lot of fun early on.
And down goes Baroche. Almost 2 times. They passed their 2 knockouts.
67 seconds and 68 seconds.
He's halfway there.
1, 2, 6.
Baroche looks at the referee instead of Kelly Long Guns. Two in the knockout department.
Very brief outing for Richard Boros, and for all those people that Pageli Wongan brought to the arena.
Good job.
They got what they wanted, but they didn't get a very lengthy show.
Fight starts at 7:20. Lead by 7:12. We check out the replay here. You really can't tell, obviously, the class of opponent. A lot to be desired here, but you can see that there's some skills there from Pageli Wongan.
Absolutely. A lot of people have been impressed by his hand speed. Again, he's a novice fighter. He's in there with a guy who is clearly overmatched, but he didn't look like a wild man in there. He put his punches together fairly well, and he did what you're supposed to do against opponents of this level.
Guy like Baroche, you got to give him at least credit for trying to withstand some of this. Well, we'll get the official time. I believe it's under a minute. Let's go up the ring announcer, Chris Gauthier.
À 59 secondes du premier round, Richard Boros corner throws the towel in at 59 seconds of the first round. The winner by TKO, le gagnant par KO technique, Mark Guapo Pageli Wongan.
Mark Pageli Wongan. Actually, I think the best part about that fight is that we don't have to say that name too many times.
Sure, we don't have to stumble over it too much, but an impressive performance from Pageli Wongan, again, doing what he needed to do in this one. And you see why Hennessy Sports Canada took a chance on him.